Welcome to Harry Sullivan is an Imbecile. I'm Brian. We have no Adam this time because, well, this is a solo effort. Anyway, I wanted to tell you about this really cool thing I did over the weekend called Doctoberfest. It's held in Canby, Indiana at Who North America. Now, if you don't know what any of that means, well, dear listener, stay tuned because all will be revealed. Doctoberfest is an annual fall festival that's held on the grounds of Who North America in Canby, Indiana. Who North America, if you are unawares, is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, merchandise store in the Midwest for Doctor Who. Not just Doctor Who, but tons of other stuff. Doctor Who's anything you would think that would be in the Doctor Who orbit. So not just like, you know, the bit stuff that you would find for like Big Finish or, you know, Iris Wildtime or anything like that, but like Dark Shadows and Blake Seven and the Avengers and you know, Jerry Anderson and all this in Space 1999. And, you know, it's really kind of cool. So anything that you would think is kind of within the realms of what would be Doctor Who, well, it's there. Red Dwarf, Robin Hood, all these things. It is a really cool store. They have tons of merchandise there. Games, action figures, sonic screwdrivers, there's all sorts of toys that you can get. They even have like little FASA miniatures. They still have some of those left from the 80s. T-shirts, posters, books, fiction, nonfiction. Now, the Peter Haining books that I grew up with are available from Who in North America. It's really cool. Just anything that you would think you would find in a Doctor Who store. Even jelly babies. They even have jelly babies, but not the bath sits, unfortunately, which are my preferred, but your mileage may vary. But yeah, Who North America, if you have never been there, check it out. It is, I'm in Cincinnati, so for me it's about a 2-hour drive, and it is a great store and run by really, you know, enthusiastic, incredible people. It's not just a store. It's also a museum. There is a museum of merchandise on the grounds there, in that building. And it is phenomenal. It is like, it's kind of, you know, almost goes from like 1963 on. But you use the toys, you know, Daleks, books, you know, the original books, old Doctor Who magazines, the action figures, mint in box, craft stuff that people have done, the Doctor Who role-playing game, games, other games that have come out. Really cool, amazing stuff. And there's a Cyberman on duty there, which is really cool. And when you walk into the store, on your left is a Dalek that just screams, "Exterminate!" at you. And there's a TARDIS, and there's a TV, and it's probably playing a Doctor Who episode for you. So it's just like a big, you know, woolly scarf hug to go to Who North America. And I've used them off and on since about 2000 when Big Finish started distributing the new audio adventures that they were doing back then with Peter Davison and Colin Baker and Sylvester McCoy. It's they're an amazing resource. If you need a doctor, if there is something in your life that is Doctor Who, they probably have it. So give them a check out. Anyway, Doctoberfest, around about 2015, they decided they had just moved to this new area that had kind of a big yard to it. So they decided they were going to be able to they wanted to do a little fall festival, a little Doctor Who related fall festival, and call it Doctoberfest. So, you know, just have, you know, fans get together and have a good time and, you know, visit the museum and buy some stuff because, oof, you can't walk out of that store without buying something unless you have really good self-control. But yeah, so, and it's become this thing that they've done every year. I think they took some time off for, they had to take time off, obviously, for COVID, but they came back in 2021, and that was the first time I had gotten to go, because that's when I first heard about it. And then we left last year, and they had kind of expanded to not just have it at the store, but to have some stuff at a nearby hotel. So there was a shuttle that would take you to there's a shuttle that takes you to the hotel, and for, you know, panels and other vendor rooms and stuff like that. Last year they had They didn't have a guest. They had some Zoom calls, I guess you would call them. So one was Sadie Miller, who we all know is the daughter of Brian Miller and Liz Sladen, of course, and has played Sarah Jane for a Big Finish. There was one with David J. Howe, a couple other, you know, guys who had played monsters and stuff like that. So, but this year is different. So this year is the 25th anniversary of Who North America being in business. They've been in business since 1998. And did you know this is the 60th anniversary of Doctor Who? I know, right? You know, we're less than a month away from that, so from the date at least. I know we have the three dates. I believe it's what, the 1st, the 17th, and the 23rd, which none are related to the specials. So, hey, wow. We all know when it's going to air. It's less than a month away. It's just like Chibnall's back in charge, dude. Wow. Hey there, this is Brian with a Doctor Who news break. So, it actually was revealed today that we have air dates for the upcoming specials. So, November 25th on BBC One is going to be Star Beast, which is the adaptation of the Doctor Who magazine comic strip. So I'm really excited for that, of course. And then December 2nd, Wild Blue Yonder. And then on December 9th, The Giggle. So Russell T. Davies posted this earlier today on Instagram, along with a video of David Tennant as 14, sonicking the date onto the screen. and then he kind of ends with a really kind of creepy smile that's really kind of scary. Good God. But we'll put a link to that in the notes, and so there we go. We have an air date, and I'm going to, we'll just excuse Smarmy past me, and that's all I gotta say. We're passing it back to me. Here you go, me. So, Doctoberfest 2023 had a special 60th anniversary, and for the first time had a guest. And it is coincidentally, it was the 25th anniversary of Who North America, and they get somebody from the 25th season of the classic series, and that was Sophie Aldred, that we all know plays Ace, and has played Ace on in Big Finish, and recently, well, I say recently, it's been a year, appeared on the screens back as Ace in Power of the Doctor, Jodie Whittaker's last story, with Janet Fielding as Tegan. She was there, and they had a few other panels there. The Doctor Who Collectors podcast was there. You know, really cool guy. Larry Vans Mersbergen. I apologize, Larry, if I'm butchering your name. I apologize. Also, there was Troika Brodsky. This is a guy who collects on-air used sonic screwdrivers, and he had some on display. He actually has I believe he has like an exhibition going on right now in St. Louis. As part of the Madman with a Box thing that they've got going over at the St. Louis Science Center. But he actually has some screen-used sonic screwdrivers, such as, you know, the one that Matt Smith holds up that explodes in the 11th hour. There was, you know, nine tens screwdriver. You know, the 13 screwdriver, and, you know, and then there were some replicas of the current screwdriver that just looks like a dog's breakfast, if you ask me. So also Brandon Peters, who has a podcast, was there, the Brandon Peters Show, and he was recording people. And of course, you know, the biggest guest, as I mentioned before, was Sophie Aldred. And I don't get to do these sorts of things that often, so this... last time I had done like a Doctor Who festival thing that wasn't Doctoberfest was probably, that actually was Doctor Who, you know, focused, was probably 1987. Wow. Yeah. So, that was a 1 day thing, and, Sarah Sutton was the guest. So I got to meet Sarah Sutton today. Woo. But yeah, so 1987, 2023, that's a huge gap between, meeting Doctor Who on air people. And that's okay. You know, life's been fun, but it was a chance to meet Sophie. And when I found out I was already looking forward to Doctoberfest, and so was, you know, my partner and my friends. And when I found out that Sophie was going to be there, I was like, oh my God, we have to go. So, my friend bought the tickets to the panels for a birthday present, you know, And then my girlfriend bought me, bought the chance for me to get my picture taken with Sophie. So I got to have my picture taken with Sophie and chit-chatted with her for, 20 seconds at, where I don't think I sounded like a complete idiot. So, she's wonderful. She's absolutely wonderful. And, for anybody who's ever met her at a convention before, or bumping into her anywhere, she is just this incredibly, genuinely sweet, kind, happy person. So it's really awesome. So after that, Sophie had a panel, and we sat in on that. It was mostly just her taking questions. So, I asked a question as to what her favorite Wilderness Years video was. So, the stuff that they released direct to video, like The Stranger or Mythmakers or stuff like that. I said, what is your favorite and why is it Shakedown? So, and she answered that, of course it's Shakedown. So, which is really funny. But she talked about her experiences doing Shakedown with Carol Ann Ford and Jane Chappell and Brian Croucher and Michael Wisher and all these people, and was on this ship, and she said it was really cool. So it was a really fun experience. She talked about some of the other things she did, like Mythmakers, talked about the Stranger story that she was in, which it was a Colin Baker and I want to say Nicola Bryant's thing, but maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. But yeah, it was a fun panel. It was recorded. I don't know if it's actually going to be released anywhere, but hey, hope springs eternal. We didn't spend a lot of time doing a lot of the panels. There was some the costume contest. There was all these really cool things. And there was another panel. It was actually the gentleman who does the collector's podcast was doing 60 items in 60 minutes. Goodness gracious. So he had like one item from every year from 1963 to 2023. So it was really cool. I actually got diverted from that before going to that because I got actually that's where I met Troika Brodsky and was looking and was just astounded by these amazing, screen-used sonic screwdrivers that he brought. There's a few other guys, people there with collections, and I chatted with them. If you listen to the Collector's Podcast Doctoberfest preview, he talks about a lot of the stuff that he's going to be he brought, and anything I would say humble, would be humble in comparison to the stuff that he talks about. So I recommend you checking that episode out. I know. Do we talk about other people's podcasts on podcasts? Shock, horror. But actually, as I was saying, I got diverted by the collector's room, which was where a lot of his other stuff was. And as well as, a few of the collectors. There was one guy who had lots of items from Kablam, so like the tape and the bomb and all, and I think even the glove of one of the Kablam robots, which is really cool. And I mean, if you find a niche, that if that's your niche, go to it, go do it, man. And then, old books, and there was the old, PVC Daleks that were made back in the 64, when there was the fire and all that. And it was just, it is, what can I say? Doctoberfest is really a fun experience. And if you are in Indiana or within a goodly, travel range of Indiana, especially in the Canby, southern Indiana area, I highly recommend you check it out. Go to Who North America in the meantime, between now and the next Doctoberfest, which we do know what the date is, October 19th, 2024, so mark your calendars now. But yeah, check out Who North America because it's just an amazing store. They have limited hours, so go onto their website. If you go to www.whona.com, that's Who North America. I think they're open like Mondays 11 to 4 and then Tuesdays 11 to 6. Fridays 11 to 8. So it's a really cool place. You know, check out their website, look at some of the stuff that they offer. They have, if you look at their About Us page, they have a couple pictures of the facility, and so you kind of, that's not even close to an accurate current representation of what they have at Who North America. It's far bigger now, but yeah, give them a check out. And then Doctoberfest next year is going to be October 19th, as I said. Not sure who the guest is yet, but it does sound like they're going to repeat it because it was such an amazing event. And I want to thank Who North America for putting this on, but most especially I wanted to thank the volunteers who helped make this thing happen, because it is a volunteer-run event. You know, it's to support the store, obviously, and I'm all for that, because it's an amazing store, and the amazing volunteers that were there that day that just made the whole thing fun, and they were all friendly and charming, and, you know, maybe some of them understood what was going on, maybe some of them didn't, but that's okay. But yeah, just so thanks to the staff at Who North America, thanks to the volunteers, Royal Limo for the shuttling, you know, all the sponsors and everything like that. Just, it was great. It was a fun time, and I will definitely be there next year, because why not? So, all right. So I just wanted to just kind of give a little bit of a, you know, a little bit of a talk about what I got to do this weekend, because it was so freaking cool, y'all. But yeah, I just wanted to share what an amazing time I had at Who North America and Doctoberfest. If you're in the area, go check them out. It's worth it. Definitely check out Doctoberfest next year. It is a fun time. And you know, you'll see me there. So that's another reason to go, right? Yeah, there you go. Anyway, thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to kind of enthuse about the stuff that I did this weekend, because it was a lot of fun. And, of course, you can find us on Twitter at imbecilepod, email us at imbecile@gmail.com, and we are, of course, on WordPress, imbecilepod.wordpress.com, and that's where I will have show notes as well as pictures of some of the stuff that we did there. And then also, I will post a few pictures from the museum that I had gone to when I went to about 2 years ago, because it was one of those things where it's like, holy hell, I gotta take a picture of everything. So yeah, look forward to that. And until next time, Adam and I will be back, and we will see you soon. Or we'll hear you soon, or maybe you'll hear us. Who knows? What is real anyway, right? All right. Thank you very much for listening, everybody. Have a great time. So long.
Shut up!